Predatory journals. Now, what is a predator or who is a predator? A predator is one that harms others, and that is what is predatory journals. Predatory journals are those that are meant to harm you. So basically, if you are writing a research paper, sending it, be very, very careful if it is an authentic journal or it is a predatory journal. Predatory journals do not have any editorial board. There is no peer review of the article or the research paper that you are sending in. Usually, they charge a lot of amount, and the student feels that this is how papers are actually published in the journals, and they keep on actively asking for you for writing the manuscripts. Now, many of these are open access. They are freely available. As mentioned, they are of substantially poor quality, low quality. They do not have any in-house editorial board. No subject experts are present. No academicians are part of the editorial board for the research publication. They fail to adhere to all kind of guidelines that are meant for publication. They basically are trying to capture the information and then reproduce it to other sources as well, and they do not keep the promises that they owe. Moreover, they provide your content to the third party as well. So this is what is called as a definition of predatory journals. Predatory journals are entities that focus on self-interest at the expense of the scholarships or the hefty amounts that you are paying. They usually provide false or misleading information. They have websites with dead links, improper or infunctional websites that are there. They deviate from the actual publication guidelines or the actual publication rules. There is no transparency, and there are lots and lots of indiscriminated practices that are there. So lack of transparency is one of the major key factors that we focus when we explain predatory journals. Now, how was it discovered and why was it named? You would be pretty surprised that it was no one else but a librarian at University of Colorado named Jeffrey Bial. And Jeffrey Bial, while going through the list of journals and the research publications in the university, found that there are certain journals which are not up to the mark, and during that time he blacklisted certain number of journals. Later on, this came to be known as predatory journals, and his blacklisted list was known as the Cable's Blacklist. Later on, an international version of the Cable's Blacklist was released, which was in the name of Cable's International, and it talked about the list of journals internationally which are not authentic, which are charging certain amount of fees for publication without actual peer review that is there. Now, here is a list of certain predatory journals that have been commonly heard of. One of the recent cases that we have heard is the Hyderabad-based OMICS group, and this was the group which publishes more than 700 journals that was there, charging huge amount of money from the individual candidates. Later on, the false claims were verified about the peer reviews that were done, and there was a huge disagreement, and this was finally in the list of predatory journals. Now, what is peer review and why it is so important? Let's say I have written an article. Now, I send this article to any magazine, to any journal for publication. What would happen is my article would be peer reviewed by a team of experts there. Now, these team of experts would go through the content that I have written. They would proofread the language, they would understand and interpret what is there, and since they are from the same academic background, they would suggest certain changes or rectifications in the content that I have already provided. Now, this is not just a one single round that happens. There are series of rounds when you are trying to publish your paper. So, this is what is known as peer review. So, peer review is done by a team of academicians, and peer review, we could say simply, is the heart of academic culture or the heart of academic evaluation that is there. So, incorrect submissions or improper submissions are taken into account. There are positive suggestions and feedbacks given onto the content. The changes are then drafted, redrafted, and finally, everything is well set before the paper gets published. So, in order to ensure the best quality research work being published in a journal, peer review is very, very important. We have seen in recent scenes that where medical science specifically, the journals in medical science have been badly hit due to incorrect peer review, and this has led to downgrading the academic culture, the mediocre academics, and that would ultimately reflect the quality of jobs, the quality of promotions, and the future research projects that would be there. So therefore, we say peer review becomes very, very essential. Now, Cable's identification or Cable's focus while identifying the journals was very, very important. So to identify the fake journals, there were certain list of criterias that were given. How do you actually know whether this journal is fake or not? So the one best way is within your institution, within your universities, you know which of the journals have a decent impact factor, and impact factor is one of the basic criteria. Then next, you go through the editorial board, whether there is an editorial board or not, the journal has academic expertise or not, and does that journal provide you sufficient information? Sometimes they do not have sufficient information that is disclosed about the author's fees, about the publication charges, about the slots of peer reviews that would be there. Sometimes they charge hidden fees. So with an authentic journal, you won't have any hidden fees that would be charged. Also, there are interesting scenarios where the name of the journal is totally unrelated to the content or the mission of the journal that is there. For example, if a journal deals on electronics, the name has to be somewhere related to electronics or science, but the name is something else. Similarly, the origin place of the journal and the name of the journal are totally unrelated. So whether the journal is originating from which nation, which region, which university is unrelated. As we previously mentioned, poor websites could be there, dead links could be there. This gives an indication that the journal is not well maintained. Also, the predatory journals would allow you allow plagiarism of all sorts because there is no peer review. There would be unauthorized use of licensed images. So copyright issues are commonly seen under predatory journals that are there. As we mentioned, they would take the journal, they would take the fees, hefty amount that they charge, and publish it for you, but they would take the same content and publish it at a third party place in some other name as well. So republishing of the already published paper is another major issue that is commonly seen, and a lot of times we have seen that journals usually have their whole identity which is disclosed. That means the contact person, the telephone number, the email ID, and all of these things along with the location is mentioned. But with a predatory journal, the location would be hidden. So go through the website very, very carefully before spending your energy into sending the articles for publication. Now, this was what was Bailey's classification, Jeffrey Bailey, when he initially talked about the coining of the term of predatory journals. So he basically focused on a classification which talked about the Bailey's predatory journal, the Cable's predatory journal, and then the legitimate or the authentic journals, which include the directory of open access journals. Now, the directory of open access journal, which is known as DOAJ, is a website which is community curated. It has being maintained under open access, and therefore has a list of journals that are there. Of these, very few were seen as a predatory journal. So this is how the initial suspected journals which were considered as predatory were identified, and this created threat to the existing journals that has been there. So be very, very careful before you are going for publication. And indeed, this is important part of the research ethics section in your aptitude, the research aptitude as well. We would be covering many more interesting topics under research aptitude. Stay tuned for updates from our side. Have a wonderful day ahead.